Hello and welcome to my channel. So this new Danish YouTuber by the name Typo is trying to launch the hashtag Olitober, which is supposed to be for Olivetti's in October, what Septandy is for Tandy's in September. And he convinced me to join in. Problem is, I don't really have any Olivetti computer, so I needed to think about what I was going to do. And then I realized that my very first real computer was actually a Olivetti. So I asked Typo if I could borrow one of him for this video, and already the next day he showed up with an Olivetti that I could use for this video. But before we get started, please do me the favor of subscribing to my channel and liking this video. That helps me promote my content towards YouTube, and that would make me so happy. Also share it with all your friends who also liked old computers and Olivettis and stuff like that. And while you do all that, I will run the intro. Yeah! The Olivetti M24 was the first 100% IBM compatible system from Olivetti. Released in 1983, based on the Intel 8086 processor running at 8 MHz with 128 KB of memory supporting high resolution CGA graphics. The system was shipped with MS-DOS 2.1 with Olivetti branding. Even though the machine was IBM compatible, both the keyboard and the monitor used different connectors and pinouts. The keyboard was connected with a DB9 plug, which was more traditionally used for CGA monitors and serial devices, where most other IBM and clone PCs used the round DIN connector for the keyboard. For connecting the CGA monitor, they decided to go with the DB25 plug, which opens up the possibility to confuse the monitor output with the parallel port. And that also ensures that you cannot just use any random CGA monitor or keyboard without having to go and get a custom adapter for it. I got mine as a Yule present in 1994. I remember the big gifts, and I suspected they were for me, or maybe I just hoped they were. But before we got to the big packages, I got a bunch of smaller packages with floppies in. So it would have been really odd if there wouldn't have been a machine to use the floppies in as well. My machine had 512 kilobytes of memory, two 360 kilobyte floppy drives, and a green monochrome screen. The machine Typo lent me has 640 kilobytes of memory, color screen, and instead of two floppy drives, it has only one, but then it has a hard drive as well. I would have been totally ecstatic if I have had that back then. So what did I use this machine for? Well, believe it or not, I primarily used it for programming in Pascal. At this point, I have had been coding both BASIC and COMAL for some years, and also very shortly been playing around with machine code on my Commodore 64. The move from COMAL to Pascal felt really good, because I was now able to make real .exe files, which made me feel way more serious. Today, I am writing my traditional BASIC program in Pascal. I don't remember if I actually had Turbo Pascal 5.5 for my Olivetti. I might just have gotten that later, and under any circumstances, I did not have this much amount of color on it. Lo and behold, BASIC, Pascal works. Of course, I also played a little bit on it, but I have always sucked at gaming. But that Yule evening in 1994, I got some floppies, and some of them had games on them. One of the games I got was Mark 3, which is a 3D flying game, which I really never learned to play, but I played it a lot anyway, because it was really pretty and smooth to look at, even though I kept dying because I had and still have no idea about what is a mine and what is a power-up, an enemy or a pit stop. But it looks pretty good for a 40-year-old game. So first I thought those glowing things were power-ups. But it seems they explode when I try to collect it, so I guess that's a mine. I'm also pretty sure that those gates are either the exit for the next level, or maybe a pit stop, or a power up. So this time around, I seem to have passed correctly through the gates, but nothing happened. Okay, except that I died. I guess I'm still not adult enough to play this game. Moving on! This was one of my favorite games, mainly because it had a level editor, so you could make your own levels. It's called Sokoban, which is Japanese for warehouse keeper. The game is a brain puzzle. You have a bird's eye view of the warehouse, and the person you navigate around can push the boxes in the room, but he cannot pull them. So if a box gets stuck in the corner, you have to start over. The objective is to get all the boxes onto the hollow rhombuses, and then you have completed the level and go straight to the next one. This is not the only implementation of Sokoban. There are many more out there, even some modern ones which you can play in your browser. I'm going to leave the link for that one down below. And while I'm at it, I will be leaving links for all the games mentioned in this video down in the description. Sokoban was really one of the games I could spend some time on. I remember several evenings of frustration because I could not figure out a specific level, and then the thrill when I finally found the solution and solved it. Speaking about wasting time, the final game I want to show you today is called Blockout. This is a three-dimensional Tetris game that is super addictive. It was released in 1989 by the American company California Dreams, but developed in Poland. Today, when I think back to my first computer, I'm actually pretty glad I got to start from scratch. My first computer was already a retro computer when I got it. My friends had Pentium computers and PlayStations where they could play games such as Doom, Tekken, SimCity and similar exciting games. I could easily have ended up becoming a full-fledged gamer if I had access to newer hardware. But thankfully, I was stuck with a computer where the most exciting thing to do was to teach myself about computer architecture and software development. And that sparked the interest, so that when I finally got a more modern computer, I started playing with Unix on it, because that was more fun than playing games. This machine was fun to play around with, but I am not satisfied yet. I want to experience the real thing. So I will continue to hunt for a computer that matches my first one. That hard drive is way too noisy, and I really miss having to switch floppies all the time. No, I don't actually miss that, but that was part of the story, so I want to experience that again. I will end this video by dedicating it to my parents. They raised me to be curious and persistent, which is very good traits to have when you work in engineering. They also taught me that it is not just okay to be different, it is preferable to be, mainly because normal is boring. And why should I care about what other people think about me as long as I don't hurt anybody? Mom and Dad, I love you. Thanks for watching.
Thank you so much for the view. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more awesome retro content. If you wish to support this channel, you are very welcome to do so directly through Patreon or Tenor app, or by purchasing some of our merchandise. That helps a lot. Finally, you can also support us by simply watching a lot of our videos and by getting your friends to do the same.